Welcome to Nature at Doorstep. In today's video, we are going to see how to grow and harvest arbi. It's also called as taro plant or colocasia. Food is considered as the best medicine, and the best example to this statement is this arbi. A lot of medicinal properties are there inside this arbi. But unfortunately, unlike the other vegetables which has got its fame in the world of health, arbi is still struggling to get recognized. Is it? What medicinal properties are there in this? You can ask me, and the answer to this you're going to see in this entire video. But before that, if you're viewing my channel for the very first time, please do like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell icon for getting the notifications on my upcoming videos. Growing arbi is very simple. Whenever we get arbi from market, we might have noticed some small sprouts coming out on the sides of arbi. And if you see such kind of sprout, don't throw the arbi away. Rather, go and plant them in soil. In 1 week's time, you can see how nicely it has come up. And on the second week, you can see small baby leaves coming out. And in 1 month's time, you can see a proper plant growing. And in following months, you can see more number of leaves coming out. This plant is a bit bushy. So while planting, just keep in mind, you give a proper space to each plant and you place them at least minimum of 2 to 3 feet apart. When you look at the leaves, it looks like heart shape. Nature keeps teaching us so many things to its various forms. It's just that we are not observing carefully. You know why I'm saying this? To keep our heart functioning, we need omega-3 and omega-6. And these two fatty acids are rich in arbi. And not only that, a good amount of vitamin E is also present in arbi, which helps fight all kind of cardiovascular disease. I'm sure you might be knowing that water doesn't stick on lotus leaves. And in a similar way, even the arbi leaves repel water. If you know the reason as to why certain leaves repel water, just write it down in the comment section. And if you want to know the answer, just wait till I upload my next video. Until then, keep googling. You can harvest your arbi in exact 7 months from the day of sowing. These arbi plants, they doesn't have a stem. Rather, they just have the leaf stalk. And look at this stalk, how hard and thick it is. All these leaf stalks originate from a single root. I hope now you can imagine by looking at these stalks how big the root would be. Whether you are consuming these leaves or whether you are consuming the root that is underground, but just keep one thing in mind. Always boil the leaves and the root before consuming. Why I am saying this is because if you try to consume them without boiling, then you get some kind of itching sensation in your throat. And that's why I'm saying you boil it and then prepare whatever dish you want out of it. These are arbi flowers. You can make pakoda out of it, you know. It's very simple. Just wash these flowers after plucking and finely chop them. And boil it nicely for 5 to 10 minutes with salt and turmeric. And after turning the gas off, sieve out any excess water and start adding all the ingredients that are needed for making pakoda. Starting with chili, onion, turmeric, chili powder, and whatever masala that you want, you can add everything and shape it in the form of a vada and just deep fry it. It tastes really yum. Do try this and I'm sure you'll really like it. Let me show you how to remove arbi from this plant. But before that, let me tell you how to identify a plant whether it is ready for harvest or not. For that, you'll have to check on 2 things. First is the leaf color. If the leaf color turns slightly yellow, it means that the plant is ready for harvest. And the second thing is, you have to check on the leaf stalk. If the leaf stalk is falling towards the ground, it means that the tuber is completely grown and the plant is ready for harvest. Here, in this particular plant, you can see how the leaf stalk is falling towards the ground. And that's why I've chosen this particular plant for harvesting and showing it to you today. Yeah, the arbi roots have come out now. This is a perennial plant, so you have to just plant it once and you can keep harvesting every year. I'll tell you an interesting information about this root. If you happen to get an insect bite, don't panic. Just grind this root and apply this paste on the infected portion. This paste will absorb all the poison and it will prevent the poison from spreading inside your body. Looks like this root has got a nice grip to the ground. Finding it very difficult to take it. Finally it has come out. See how big the root is? Wow, it's too big. This root is rich in folate. I'm sure all mothers would have had folic acid during their pregnancy period. And even the doctors would have advised them to have folic acid during their pregnancy. And you know what? This arbi root is the main source of folic acid. So going forward, if you have any pregnant ladies in your family, just ask them to have more and more of arbi root. Not only this, this arbi root, it helps to remove all the toxins from our body. And in fact, it helps to rebuild our immunity system, as it is the best source of vitamin C. Arbi is rich in vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin E, and it also has got so many antioxidant producing minerals such as copper, manganese, magnesium, zinc, calcium, iron, potassium, beta carotene, selenium, and these antioxidants are the ones that are useful to protect us from any disease. Even people with high blood pressure can have this arbi. You know why? Because it is a low sodium food. It's zero fat, it's zero cholesterol, and full of fiber. Here you can see in this particular arbi how much fiber is coming out. And this fiber is not just outside the root, even inside the root it is full of fiber. So even the diabetic patients can have this. This arbi, it has got the power to even break the glucose in liver, and it also reduces the sugar content in blood. We all know that food gets digested, and I understand. But after absorbing all the nutrients from the food, the waste products has to get excreted, right? And you know how a cancer is formed? It is because of these waste products. If these waste products are not excreted properly, and if they stay in our intestine for a long period of time, then they produce free radicals which in turn cause cancer. Consuming this arbi, it not just flushes out all the waste materials from our body, it also acts like a barrier in protecting us from any disease. And you very well know how it is doing this, because it is full of antioxidants. Also, it's good for weight loss, as it has got zero fat, and it's good for athletes too, because it is packed with energy. I hope the video was informative. If you find my video useful, please do like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell icon for getting the notifications on my upcoming videos. Thank you.